Welcome to Damian's workshop. I'm building a PC chassis almost entirely out of Lego bricks, and today I will discuss my thoughts on how I'm planning to cool it down with fresh air as best as possible. As you know, modern PC components can output a fair amount of heat. To manage it, the whole test components are in contact with heat exchangers, which transfer thermal energy into the surrounding air. The air inside of the chassis will heat up, and if it's not replaced with fresh air from the outside, the computer will overheat. This can be dangerous to my almost 100% LEGO-made chassis because the ABS plastic from which LEGO bricks are made deforms and warps at around 80 degrees Celsius, which can be reached with a chassis with an extremely bad airflow. It's very important that I find a way to perforate my case as much as possible while keeping the structural integrity at the same time. I also want it to be aesthetically pleasing. There are many bricks which may be suitable for this application, so let's review a few of them and decide the best way to proceed. My first idea was to use either of these 1x4x2 fences. The white one has nice grill-shaped perforations, while the grey one features two knobs on its top, which would simplify building a larger repeating pattern. If we lock these two pieces from their side, you can see that the perforated part is placed right above the center of the bottom studs. This means that a flush surface, which I really want, cannot be built. A flush surface can be built with this 1x4x1 fence, which has its perforated component offset to the side. The perforated area to unperforated area ratio is quite smaller when compared to previous two fences. Even though this means less airflow, I will keep my eye on this one. Next comes this 8x8 grid plate, which almost looks like a regular computer fan hole. I like it very much, unfortunately it features studs on its top, making building a flush surface impossible. I'll put that under maybe. I don't like this 9x13 grill. I find the mounting method with holder bricks quite flimsy, and I don't want my case to drop bricks every time I touch it. Because of its framed shape, it would be impossible to create a continuous pattern. This 2x1 tile modified with grill offers a nice way to make a continuous flush surface. Pass any air through, I would have to mount it to a single stud, which would again be very flimsy. Pass. This 2x1 plate modified with a ladder is my favorite. It can be secured from two sides, from the top and from the bottom. It can form a nice flush grill pattern, and its perforated to unperforated area ratio is quite okay. One honorable mention, these lattice walls from Belleville offer the best airflow perforation ratio of all. Unfortunately, they are very expensive in larger quantities and only come in pink or white, the former being even more expensive. Maybe I'll use them later in some chassis for a girly computer. So what's next, you may ask? Right now I'm learning to print with the ABS plastic, which is a bit more challenging than printing with the PLA, from which all of my prototypes were made. But I'm getting the hang of it. In the next video I will most likely discuss the chassis layout and the PC components position and the general shape of my future PC case. Please subscribe if you're interested, and thank you for watching. I'm Damian, cheers!